In this episode of Step Into the Blue,
to get him out of there. Our objective was to find the gun.
I think he said he just made a heroic rescue. Either that or he has to hurry to the restroom. And then, we've all had it happen at one time or another. You look in the rearview mirror and you're being pulled over by the police. But this time, you'll hear about it from the officer's perspective as Class 16 learns about car stops.
Police officers come from all walks of life. Some start their careers right out of college. Others were business people, and many served in the military. But before they become police officers, all of them spend time as recruits at the police academy. Now, join the recruits of the San Jose Police Academy as they prepare to step into the blue.
After working the street for a couple of years, new officers can apply for what we call a specialty assignment. Here at the San Jose Police Department, we have over 65 specialty assignments. Now, right here, we have members of one of those specialty units, and this is the horse-mounted unit, or at least part of it. We actually have 14 horses in all that make up the horse-mounted unit. Now, what they do is they patrol the downtown area where we are right now. Also, they patrol the parks. They serve a crowd control function. And they're also wonderful ambassadors for the city of San Jose. Everybody likes to come up and pet and talk to the horses, and as well as the officers. Now, that's still a few years away for the members of Class 16, so let's check in and see how they're doing in the police academy as they prepare to step into the blue.
There is no such thing as a typical day in law enforcement. Things can literally change from minute to minute, and that requires training for incidents that might seldom, if ever, occur. Today, the members of Class 16 are participating in a training exercise involving a WMD, or a weapon of mass destruction.
Well, they are doing a WMD event. In other words, they're going to respond to what we tell them is an explosion at PAB. They're going in to rescue a downed officer in a contaminated environment. Now, it's already been swept for secondary devices and for chemical agents. So our bomb squad's been there, and so has Hazmat. Hazmat tells them that there's something in the air, but they're not quite sure exactly what it is, only that their filters will protect them as well as their personal protective gear. So these young officers are going to go in and rescue a downed officer and perhaps deal with some unique scenarios on the way through.
And regardless of whether you're talking about a night out on the town or responding to a hazmat event, proper attire is a must.
The suits that the recruits are putting on now are what we call a level C suit. It works with the APR respirator, or what most people call their gas mask. And the suit will seal up and encapsulate the officer and keep them splash-proof and have a certain level of chemical resistance to contaminants that they will find in an explosive type of environment or a biological environment or a chemical environment.
The recruits enter the scene of the simulation to rescue the injured officer, and as Recruit Mountain explains, what they found could easily have been mistaken for a Hollywood set complete with special effects. Lots of smoke, flashing lights, and screaming actors covered with fake blood.
So we went into a room that was supposed to have had a bomb go off with some kind of gas being emitted, and there's role players everywhere. They're all put up in makeup, and they're bloody, they're gory. They had parts of people laying around. They had debris everywhere we were tripping over. We went in with our team of, we have five guys, and we went and saved the officer, brought him back out to safety.
Yes, there are times when the police academy is fun, but this simulation also provides a valuable learning experience for the recruits. Now, even though they all realize that this is just a training exercise, it's still stressful, particularly when there are so many victims to be rescued. It's often under such chaotic circumstances that mistakes are made, and it's much better to make them here than during an actual incident.
Well, what happened, we did the scenario like Mountain said, and I got left behind. I was point, I found the entrance out, and I went to clear a right area, turned around and my team was gone, they left me. It's probably because I'm Fremont PD, but it's all right.
Actually, everybody in the academy is on the same team, regardless of what department you work for. That camaraderie even extends to helping your teammates scrub down during the decontamination process. And a helping hand while trying to get out of the suit is also much appreciated. As we noted earlier in the show, a police officer can be called upon to perform a wide variety of duties during a typical day. No one needs to explain that to Officer Beth Albalos, who in addition to being one of Class 16's training officers, is also their instructor today.
There is a challenge in switching back and forth from being a TO to an instructor. As a TO, it's one role, and then you have to completely change hats to be an instructor because I have to make sure that they're comfortable enough that they'll interact so that they can actually learn the material that I'm teaching them.
And today she's teaching them about cultural diversity. The state of California mandates that all police recruits attend cultural diversity training during the academy, along with a class called Disabilities Awareness. As the recruits discover, the cultural diversity class is not a spectator sport.
Typically, when I first start teaching the cultural diversity class on the first day, everyone's very quiet, they're not sure what to expect, and I have to come up with some sort of icebreaker in order to bring them out of their shell and get them talking. The best way for them to learn is for them actually to teach each other because of all their backgrounds and the diverse backgrounds that we have in the classroom. We have black, white, which encompasses Irish, German, Dutch, et cetera, English, Arabic, Egyptian, Italian, Hispanic, and I'm sure there's a few others that I'm missing, so it's pretty diverse.
And it's not long before the recruits are talking openly, sharing details about their cultural backgrounds. In a diverse community like San Jose, such training helps maintain the relationship of trust and respect with the community that they will serve as police officers.
The one thing I'd have them take away from this class is to be open-minded. Open-mindedness. And to be aware that not everybody's exactly the same. There are different ways of doing things.
It's a Thursday. The sun is shining brightly and the birds are flying overhead. On a side street just south of the San Jose International Airport, Class 16 is learning how to perform a basic part of police work, the vehicle stop. It sounds simple, doesn't it? Just pull in behind the violator's vehicle and turn on the red lights, right?
Oh, first things first. First thing you're doing, you're getting on dispatch. You're talking to dispatch. Let them know where you're going to be at. In this case, we're at Asbury and Spring Street. So you let them know your location. As you're doing that, you're hitting your seatbelt. You're hitting the lights and hitting the siren. Then as soon as you do that, you have to communicate with dispatch, give them the actual plate number on the vehicle, get out of the vehicle safely, so and operate the lights, back the lights off, turn the wheels outward, hit the emergency brake, make sure you don't catch your baton on the actual seatbelt when you're getting out so you don't hang yourself trying to get out of that vehicle. That's hard, and for me, being a big guy, it's even with a seat back, it's still difficult to unfold those legs and get out of that car and get out of it quickly and safely without falling, you know, on my hands and knees.
How did I do? I did all right.
Didn't turn his wheel out.
I turned my wheel out. But it's just all day we've been practicing, so it's getting a little easier every time.
It's always nice to have the support of your colleagues.
You got hands. He's not going.
Well, the recruits will have plenty of opportunities to practice, but right now the instructors are adding yet another element to the vehicle stop scenario. Well, that's not supposed to happen. What do you do when the driver decides not only to leave the car, but to sprint off toward the horizon? While your inclination might be to run after him, you never know who else or what else might still be in the car.
Now we're starting to do a little bit more finesse, where we're starting to, okay, now we're starting doing a little bit more investigative type of a car stop, where we're looking in to see, okay, what kind of stuff would these guys have inside their vehicle, you know, what, you know, people we're dealing with are possibly on parole, probation. Some situations we're seeing some people running out of the vehicle. So you've got all the different elements that you have to add into that.
Now, in the police business, we call this a clue that maybe this vehicle has been stolen. And the presence of such evidence allows the officers to investigate further to determine not only if that vehicle is stolen, but also if there may be some other crimes involved. During the post-scenario debriefing, training officer Matt Curley reminds the recruits to utilize all their senses during an investigation.
So smell will tip you off something's going on. Yeah, smell of alcohol, plain view, look for that stuff.
The scenarios are working great. I think if we can do these at least once or twice a week, that's probably going to give us our best training. I mean, we can learn a lot of this stuff in a book, but actually getting out of here hands-on is probably the best thing that we can do.
Sure.
Next time on Step Into the Blue.
What's going on?
An argument.
How did that happen?
We started yelling at each other. Kind of how those go.
The recruits are back in the classroom learning about domestic violence. and the members of Class 16 are running and gunning at the outdoor firing range.